team started out this season with singular goals, to make it to the NCAA tournament. Nick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the Jacksonville State Gamecocks and the Kansas Jayhawks.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Jayhawks should have a cakewalk tonight, Dick. What are the keys for them, you think?
Hey, the keys for them should be straightforward tonight. First, the point guard has to take control of the game, and he has to dictate the tempo and the pace. Secondly, pound the ball down low for some easy baskets. It'll be a bonus if we can get their big man in foul trouble. And lastly, be strong with the ball. Turnovers could be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court, and we'll see how this one plays out. Jumps in, drops the bucket despite the harm.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. He pulls the trigger, way off target.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He launches the bomb. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
Inside, Spander handles the pass. He stole the ball. Great pressure there.
Fantastic ball pressure. The pressure got to the ball handler, and he lost it. Great play to take that to the basket.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Fed the low block. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork, really excellent. Great effort defensively. He says, thou shalt not enter my lane, baby. Get it out of here. I'm the landlord.
Spander receives the pass. And up. And he missed. Takes care of the ball until the offense resets. Dickey still applying great pressure on the dribbler. He tries the three. He gets the bucket. Buchanan receives the ball. Defender knocked the ball loose, but the offense got it back. He takes the shot off the baseline. Great shot.
That's absolutely sensational, even a second time.
Trying to pack it inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The Jayhawks seemingly have a solid number of seniors in their lineup, Dick.
Hey, Brad, you know I love seniors. By the time they're in their fourth year of eligibility, they're a solid and reliable basketball player.
10 seconds to put it up. The center handles the feed. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He'll regroup the offense. Inside. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
He's got the post flashing if he wants it. On the outside, he unloads a three. Off the rim and no good. The elbow, they feed down to the low block. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork, really excellent on a post play. I tell you, didn't waste any time. He got the ball in the right position, and then what it does, it keeps the defensive player away from blocking the shot when you make that turn.
Length of the floor. Stolen. Gave it up. The bucket. Perfectly executed. Conte is feeling good.
Hey, can you blame him, Brad? He's getting it done.
Defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick, but so's the defense, and they do a nice job. He takes the shot. Shot clock is dead. On the dribble, gives it up. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
He shoots. Way off target. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I'll tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
At halftime, the Jayhawks trail by five. Kansas heads into the locker room after just a horrible half of shooting from the field.
I mean, you're being kind. I don't even consider that shooting. I call that throwing up bricks, man, and prayers and hoping they would fall. Terrible shooting by this ball club. I cannot believe it. You can't win shooting like that.
Dick, these kids have battled through a first half. They battled through an entire season and their conference tournaments, and now it's down to who's got some gas left in the tank.
I'll tell you what, momentum's so important. You've got to try to go on a little spurt now, because anybody who gets the lead is really putting the pressure on the club that would be behind.
They work it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. An easy one.
This is simply a great play, Brad.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The lay-in. They work the perimeter. In the paint. For the deuce. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
On the outside. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Lobs it. Hopkins draws the personal. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches. I think right now, they're gonna focus defensively.
Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper, looking for contact. Finger roll. For two, he can't miss.
Hey, this young man's feeling it, Brad.
Despite the hack. Tries for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. They still don't score. Up, easy one. Puts it up, looking for contact. Easy one. West checking courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, an emotional message from both benches. Let's play our game. That's what got us here. And more importantly, let's believe in one another. Guys?
Dick, look at the number of points off turnovers.
I tell you, getting baskets off turnovers is such a great and easy way to score, Brad. You want to maximize these opportunities as much as you can.
Shot to go.
Look at that great defense right there. Not allowing them to make the turn.
Conti handles the feed. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
He can't get one to fall. He hits the second.
We've got ourselves a dandy here, folks.
The lead has been trimmed to four. Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Games like this, Brad, offensive and defensive execution is very important. Pushing that basketball.
He tries the three. He can't get the hoop to fall. I'm out on the court, so let's go courtside. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
I think she's right about that, Richie. Well, let's see who will benefit the most out of that timeout, Dick. Two-point game. He keeps the dribble as they reset. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. Maybe some game plan changes, Dick.
You never know what's coming, Brad.
This place will go senseless, Dick, if they can get a stop.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from the top of the circle, pulls down the board.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way to be able to get some fast break opportunities. No matter how you describe it, a stop here will excite all of the fans. Dump it inside.
Looking for a screen on top and got it. Gave it up. The shooting guard with the ball. Buchanan is looking for some encouragement from the fans.
I guess he feels that this defensive possession is a big one.
10 seconds to get a shot off. He shows patience waiting for the reset.
I tell you, he missed the post. I had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Spander receives the pass. He fires away. Off the rim and no good. And we are headed for overtime.
I hope not too many fans gave up their seats, Brad. At the end of the second half, it's a dead heat. These teams are going into overtime.
NCAA tournament, and it is overtime, a tournament game. Two evenly matched teams, Dick. This has been great throughout regulation. I can't wait for the OT.
Hey, I'll tell you one thing. Does it get any better than this? You talk about awesome, baby. Overtime game in the NCAA tournament. Wow. How golden is that?
Tries for two.
Replay, please. Nice high post screen.
That one goes back from whence it came. The ball goes out of bounds. Dick, we get a look here at the front court players and how they're performing.
Who can dominate the paint is the question, Mr. Nessler. Sometimes the bigs get lost with all of the guard play, but to win consistently, you need to have a balanced attack inside and outside.
Rims out.
This defender is resilient, still applying pressure.
In and out. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
It's a fast break possibility. He gets that one to fall. Tries the three ball.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
He wants a three. Off the rim and no good. Dick, any advice for the offense against this zone?
If they move in a little quicker and stop thinking so much, they just might catch these guys off guard.
Yeah, they are really a little stagnant out there.
Double team now, bad angle.
He looks for three.
They better find a way to get some easy buckets to get their confidence back, Brad.
Absolutely. They got to get it going here. He attempts a jump hook. Kansas are on a nice little run at the moment.
Hey, they have to keep pushing and seeing if they can't force a timeout.
got the high pick.
He shoots from the top of the key. On the dribble, gives it up. Trying to come up with a steal. And he'll kick it back outside. He shoots from left of the circle. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win.
Look at that spacing.
He gives him the fake for the bucket, and he missed. Takes away the pass. They work the perimeter. Goes up for two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
For something different here coming out of this timeout, Dick.
I wouldn't doubt it, Brad.
That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Boy, it's so important when you're getting points off turnovers. Look at that stat.
I'll tell you one thing, coaches go nuts. If that stat's negative, it absolutely makes you lose the air and you get balled like I am.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
And now the fadeaway jumper. They're really losing confidence with their poor shooting at the time, Dick.
Hey, nothing that a couple of fast break dunks couldn't cure.
The Jayhawks have a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
Cross court. And we've got a whistle and a foul. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I'll tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
I got to be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
Right, Brad. They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
Foul, and that stops the clock again.
Nobody likes this part of the game when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
The clock stopped with a foul. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
Makes the second shot. Timeout on the floor. We'll have a little break in the action here, partner, while both teams talk it over. Get ready to resume the action. Dick, is 10 points safe at this point?
Are you kidding me? 10 scratches wouldn't be safe with a half of this time left.
For the deuce. And off the mark. And yet another foul. He goes to the line. Makes the front end of the one and one. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Have to make the free throw. For two. Up. Easy one. Bryant receives the ball. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. They'll work it around the arc. The Jayhawks are in the bonus. He is going to the line. Up and in. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Buries it. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
Went away from the post and goes the other way. The center takes the feed. Fakes it. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Dick, you've said it so many times, survive and advance. Well, one survived and will advance. The other one's going home now.